שלום, 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 חברים שלי. Hello, my friends. חבר, friend, חברים שלי. My friends. מוכנים? Ready? מוכנים? יאללה. Let's go. I hope you are reviewing what we are doing in these lessons. We have booklets. I'm reminding you, we have booklets for reviewing. Print it out. You just have sentences side by side. Close one side, read the other, check yourself. And because lessons are building upon each other. So, but we are also reviewing in the lessons themselves. So, let's see. Do you remember how to say she's running to a bus? She. Mm-hmm. He, she's he, which is kind of funny if it's the first time you hear it. By the way, I found a very funny video, but on Facebook, I'll post the link below to the funny video with the he's she, she's who. Who is... He and she is, yeah, I'll post the video. She's running to a bus. Mm-hmm. He ratsa le autobus. Remember running ratsa? We did some verbs last time. Ratsa, she's running. Now, she's running to a bus we had here. And what if she's running to the bus? How do we say to the, remember? Mm-hmm. Le and ha merge together. Merge together and we're getting la. You see le from here, a from here, together we're having la to the, like be and ha we got ba, le and ha we're getting la. Okay, so to the bus, la. She is running to the bus. He ratsa la autobus. Excellent. He is running to work, to the work, we say in Hebrew, every day. Remember every day? Let's say it. Hu ratz la avoda kol yom. Hu ratz la avoda kol yom. And reviewing something from the last time. I am not running to work every day, to the work every day. Mm-hmm. I am speaking feminine. You use the feminine. Ani lo ratza la avoda kol yom. Let's ask a question. Why? Remember how to ask why? We had it last time. Why? Lama. Lama. The answer to lama is because. How do we say because? A short word. Ki. Mm-hmm. And then let's say because I would answer my work is here at home. We did it last time. It's a review. Because my work, mine, no, is here at home, in the house. Ki ha'avoda sheli kan, babayit. Ha'avoda sheli kan, babayit. Okay, this is bayit. This is, for me, it's a kind of office, right? How do we say office in Hebrew? Mm-hmm. Misrad. Now let's ask a rhetorical question. What is it work in an office? Like, I mean, rhetorical. What is it like? What is it work in an office? How do we say what is this? Now, work in an office. Office, misrad. Think. Here we have it. Maze avoda b'misrad. Maze avoda b'misrad. Okay. Let's say it's order, lots of coffee, and again, I'm inventing sentences because I'm trying to be using same words again and again to show how the kind of concepts work, helping. So sometimes it's kind of nonsense, but I'm trying to make it. It's order, lots of coffee, and it's order, remember? Mm-hmm. Ze seder harbe. A lot, many and a lot, same word, harbe. We didn't make it, but I assume maybe you know it. Harbe, a lot, harbe, cafe, coffee is cafe. And ve, here's a new word for us. Maybe you know it. There is, and there is. Do you know how do we say in Hebrew there is? Yesh. And I need it for using this sentence. There is a boss. Boss. Director. How do we say there is a boss? Yesh, boss. Let's make this whole long, long sentence together. We have all the ingredients. Work in an office. It's order. Lots of coffee. And there is a boss. Good or not good? Let's break it into pieces. Work in an office. Avoda babait. It's order. Ze seder. Lots of coffee. Harbe cafe. And ve there is. Yesh a boss. Boss. Yesh boss. Good or not good? Here we go. Tov or lo tov? Avoda b'misrad, ze seder, harbe cafe, ve yesh boss. Tov or lo tov? Okay, that's about working in the office. Avoda, work in office. Avoda b'misrad. And what is it work at home? How would you ask a question? Ma ze avoda b'bayit? Ma ze avoda b'bayit? Well, my answer would be, it's a mess, lots of tea, maybe because I'm talking about myself, I drink tea, I don't drink coffee for some reason, I don't know why. It's a mess, lots of tea, and it's a mess, how do we say it? A mess, do you know how to say mess in Hebrew? Balagan, balagan. We had a word for order, seder, here we have a word for mess, the opposite, balagan. Lots of harbe, and coffee is cafe, tea is te. Ze balagan, harbe te, ve. And there is no. How do we say in Hebrew there is no? No, no, not what you thought. You say there is and then no, no. We have a special word that means there is no. Don't use the word for there is. There is yesh, and there is no, it's ein. Okay, special word for there is no. Now you can say there is no boss. How do we say there is no boss? Ein boss. Ein boss. Mm-hmm. It's phonetical, that's why one S, you know. Okay. All together. Work at home, it's a mess, lots of tea, and there is no boss. Avoda babayit, ze balagan. Harbe te ve ein boss. Okay. And my conclusion is, work at home is a mess, but it's fun. Work at home, avoda babayit, it's a mess, ze balagan, but, aval, ze kef. The word for fun is kef. It's written with an E, with a U there, but people pronounce it as kef mostly, written as kef. Actually, but kef, people say kef. Afas the kef. Okay, now, let's move on. Now, you remember very well that there is yesh, there is no ein. Okay, now, the new thing for today is how do we say I have? For saying I have, we actually say, we do not say I have, we say there is to me. There is to me. And this is there is, we know, yes. How do we say to me? To me, we know how to say to. Remember, we were running to the bus. How do we say to? Le. And then you put the I, ani. You put le and ani together, and that's what we have. Li. It have, it's like same thing, you remember, with the be and ha, they merge. And that's how they merge. Le and ani, when they merge, le. The first letter here and the last letter together, we have li. So, li is to me. There is to me. So, now, I have in Hebrew is actually, we are not saying I have. We do not have the verb have. And I keep talking about it in the full course all the time. We do not have the verb have. We have to use other means to express possession. So, we say there is to me. There is to I, literally. And that's yesh li. So how do we say I have good work or I have good job? Yesh li avoda tova. How do we say I have a mess at home? I'll give you a second to think. I have mess at home. Yesh li balagan babayit. Yesh li balagan babayit. I have lots of time. Yesh li harbe zman. Now, how do we say there is no reviewing? Remember? Ein. Special word, ein. Now, how would we say then, I don't have? Remember, we don't have the verb to have. So what we're actually saying, there is no. There is no or not to me. There is no to me. Ein li, as you correctly guessed, I hope. Ein li. So how do we say I don't have time today? Ein li zman hayom. I don't have order at home. Ein li seder babayit. Now let's have a new word, maybe not new, friend. Friend. It's something that's good to have when talking about having or not having. Friend is chaver. Chaver. Oh, by the way, cultural note. Chaver can also mean boyfriend. We don't have a special word for boyfriend, so how do we distinguish? It's difficult. We just say maybe, No, chaver. It would probably to intensify a boyfriend who would say chaver, chaver. But it's just, it's not a rule, it's just something that people do. Okay, I have a friend. Just a friend. I have, remember? Yesh li. Yesh li chaver. I have good friends. Let's make it plural. I have good friends. Yesh li stays the same. Good friends, we need plural for that. Friend, chaver, friends, chaverim. Good friend, chaver tov. Good friends, chaverim tovim. I have good friends. Yesh li chaverim tovim. Excellent, very good. Now let's have another verb actually here. Comes like come home or something. In Hebrew it's ba. When written in Latin letters, it's very provocative even, because they say ba, it's like in the, ba bite, ba autobus, and here it's ba. But when you learn the alphabet, and do learn the alphabet, and please do learn to read and to spell, spelling is very important. In the course, I do teach and write a lot and check spelling. And then, you know, it just takes several attempts and then you know how to spell. Now, ba comes, he comes is written with an aleph, bet aleph, two letters, and ba in the is written with one letter and it's a prefix, it sits together with the word. Okay, he comes on time. Remember, on time is in time. He comes, hu ba bazman, hu ba bazman. Now, why doesn't he come on time? How do we ask this question? Why do we don't have those, so why not come in time, literally? Okay, why doesn't he come on time? Lama hu lo ba bazman? Lama hu lo ba bazman? Let's answer. Every day he comes on time to work. Every day, some time to think, and here's the answer. Kol yom hu ba bazman la avoda. Here we see the two. Ba, here it will be bet aleph, and here it will be just bet together with the word time. Kol yom hu ba bazman la avoda. Next one. I feel like doing something. Why is it here actually? I feel like doing something. Lama. Ki, because. This I feel like we express with a very special, it's a very special expression in Hebrew. I feel like we say, it comes to me. Okay, literally, ba li comes to me. So it means like suddenly I have this desire, ba li. I feel like ba li. I feel like having some coffee. It would be comes to me coffee. That would be ba li cafe. I feel like having an ice cream now. I feel like eating an ice cream now. Ba li glida achshav. I feel like running. And here is something, some teachable moment here. I feel like running. For that, I will have to use, I feel like to run. It comes to me, what comes to me? To run. And to, remember how we say to. Le or la depends. Now, to in the verbs, maybe it's a coincidence, maybe not, is also le. So when in English you see to, then in Hebrew it definitely starts with L. You don't know if it will be L, La, or Le, or Li, you don't know, but basically it's L. So, to run, remember how we say Ratz, Ratz, Ratzim, Ratzot, to run is Larutz. So, it comes to me to run. Ba, Li, Larutz. So it's the first time when we meet infinitives in the course, and I will just teaching here, and it's a mini course. I'm teaching just tiny bits and samples, real work in the course. So I don't feel like running today. So that was I feel like running today. How to say I don't feel like running today? It doesn't come to me to run today. To run is larutz. Lo ba li larutz. Hayom. I have time. I don't feel like running. Like I'm not in a hurry. I don't feel like running. So that would be I have time. Here we're reviewing the have word. I have time. Now I don't feel like running. Got it? Let's see. Yesh li zman lo ba li larutz. Lo ba li larutz. And actually about this ba li or lo ba li, I have a whole newsletter. I don't know if you're subscribed to my newsletter. If not, I will put the link down below. Please go and subscribe to my newsletter. I had just a recent issue of my newsletter, Hebrew Tip, number 33 already. Wow. And that's, it was exactly about it. So I'll put the link to this topic about Bali, Lo Bali, and then down below there is a form. You can subscribe. You'll receive it every Friday to your email, this newsletter. Okay, let's go on. Have, I have. Again, how do we say I have? There is to me. Okay, just shake it off. This comes to me. Bali, okay, put it aside for a second. I have. Yesh li. Yesh li chaverim be Tel Aviv. Now, back to that. I feel like living in Tel Aviv. I feel like comes to me. To live. How would we say to live? Remember, live. Gar, gara, garim, garot. To live must start when you see to. You don't see to, but it comes to me. To live. When you need to, then you say to live. Lagur. So it comes to me to live in Tel Aviv. Bali lagur be Tel Aviv. Bali lagur be Tel Aviv. And here I since we have this chaverim and Bali, I'm thinking about a song about Tel Aviv and Yerushalayim. It has they sing Yerushalayim hineni ba, Tel Aviv hineni ba, and about a guy who was moving from Tel Aviv to Yerushalayim, and each time he thinks that this city is the best and it's forever. This is the song. This song shall Dag Nachash. Yeah, it's a Dag Nachash is a funny, it's a nice group. General Israeli music is great. Again, this link, I'll post this link down below in the video and in the booklet. It will be all over the place. Okay, and let's keep going. Okay, now let's look at the infinitive of the get up. We had he gets up, she gets up. Remember how do we say it? Come, kama. Now, how do we make the infinitive? Gar, he lives. To live, you take the to, l. Gar, lagur. Kam, lakum. I nearly said it. Kam, lakum. Kam, lakum. Ratz, larutz. Gar, lagur. Kam, lakum. Do you hear it's the same kind of music to it? I don't feel like getting up at 6. I don't feel like to get up. It doesn't come to me to get up at 6. Lo bali lakum beshesh. Okay, bali is a slang expression. It's not the standard expression. What's the standard word for I feel like? I want. Or he wants, she wants. How do we say it? Wants. Rotse. Rotse. How would a boy say I don't want? Say Ani lo rotse. I don't want. Ani lo rotse. I don't want to live here. To live. Mind this form. This is the to form. אני לא רוצה לגור כאן. אני לא רוצה לגור כאן. And if a girl is speaking about herself, then we're having the normal general ending for a girl, the a ending. So if the boy was רוצה, the girl would be רוצה. Be very careful because we had the verb she's running. Yeah, he רצה. She wants. He רוצה. Two different verbs. This student, the feminine student, wants to get up at 6. How would you say it? התלמידה רוצה לקום בשש. התלמידה רוצה לקום בשש. I wonder. We. That's another one we didn't talk about. We had אני. For I, we had את and אתה, which is a boy, which is a girl. אתה is a boy, את is a girl. We had who and he last time in the third lesson, he and she. And now we have we, and I'll stop at this point. Again, in full course, I do cover all the person pronouns. In any case, you can have a, find a list on the net. But we, we is אנחנו. And we, usually it's me and someone else. So these are many people. So if I want to say, we want to live in Tel Aviv, I would say, try to guess. Here we go. אנחנו רוצים לגור בתל אביב. רוצים, we want to, plural, רוצים. אנחנו רוצים לגור בתל אביב. Let's ask them, why? למה? And they would answer, or, I don't know, because in Tel Aviv there is lots of work. It's a big city. Yeah, many job opportunities, I mean, but I'm trying to use these. This sentence is kind of awkward because I'm, again, limited vocabulary and trying to make the to build as much as possible out of the few words because we don't have many cognates in Hebrew, so I'm using just a few words to build the sentences. So, because in Tel Aviv there is lots of work. כי, it's not he, it's כי. כי בתל אביב, there is, יש, a lot, הרבה עבודה. כי בתל אביב יש הרבה עבודה. And we want to live in a kibbutz, someone says. And, how do we say and? We want. ואנחנו רוצים לגור בקיבוץ. And we want to live in a kibbutz. Maybe you want to ask now, what is a kibbutz? How do you ask it? Right. מה זה קיבוץ? מה זה קיבוץ? קיבוץ is, קיבוץ זה. You give me the answer. Write in comments, what's kibbutz? Google it, Wikipedia. You know, Google. And if you don't know it, find it out. This, if you don't know, it's a fascinating chapter in our history, kibbutz. But it's not over, but it changed. Well, you research, that's your homework. Research about kibbutz and what's kibbutz. And let's keep the conversation going. In kibbutz, there's also lots of work. Yeah, how do we say it? By the way, also goes in front. Hebrew likes to put also in front. Gam bekibbutz. Oh, it's okay to put it in other places, but just it's the tendency is in the front. Gam bekibbutz. Also in kibbutz. Gam bekibbutz. Yesh harbeh avoda. And let's ask a question. Do you want to live in a kibbutz? Like, let me, maybe I am asking you. And I could ask, maybe, if you are a boy, I would ask, אתה רוצה לגור בקיבוץ? And if you're a girl, I would ask, את, and here I must change the ending, את רוצה לגור בקיבוץ? It depends what you find about kibbutz, and if you like it or you don't like it. את רוצה לגור בקיבוץ? אתה רוצה לגור בקיבוץ? And this is it for this lesson. Well done, כל הכבוד, and you are really doing great, and just keep it up. Keep doing. Remember the booklets, download the booklets, and I'll be posting the links I mentioned here and crediting the guy from whom I got the idea of this series. And this is it for today. And see you next time. You are doing great, guys. Keep it up. See you. Bye. Later.